everyone, my name is Uliana, I work at Certifier, and in this video I'll be showing you how you can connect Google Forms to Certifier via Zapier in under 10 minutes. So keep watching this video if you would like to automatically issue certificates to everyone who submits your Google Form. Let's get started. So I would like to start with the foundations. What is Zapier and how does it work? So Zapier allows you to connect two or more apps via automated workflows that are called Zaps. It's very important to highlight that you don't need any coding skills to set up such integrations. So each Zap consists of two events. A trigger event, it is the event that starts your Zap, and the action event, it is the event that your Zap performs. So given the title of this video, we want to make sure that each time when we receive a new form response in Google Forms, a Certifier certificate is automatically generated and distributed to the person who submitted this form. I know it may sound tricky, but trust me and trust the process. Once you see me creating and setting up those Zaps, you'll understand that it is literally a piece of cake. So what do you need to set up such an integration? Basically, everything that you need is a Zapier account on a free or a higher plan, a Certifier account on a free or a higher plan with at least one group created, and your Google Form. Once you have everything prepared, let's go to Zapier. So here we have our Zapier dashboard. I'll make myself smaller and move my face down here. And now we have to click on the Create Zap button. So we are redirected to our Zap creation process. And now we have to select the event that's going to trigger our Zap. So as you remember, it is Google Forms. Let's select Google Forms. And let's go with the event, with an event called new form response, because we would like a Certifier certificate to be automatically issued each time when a new form response is received. So new form response is the right event. And let's hit continue. Now we have to select the account. As you can see, there is already my account here, but you'll have to click on this button, connect a new account, and go through the authorization process. I'll skip it because I have already done so. And let's hit the continue button. And now we have to select the form, the data from which we would like to import to Certifier. So here is this form, the one that I created in Google Forms. Let's find it. Here it is, work request, continue. And now we have to test the trigger. So Zapier has to check whether the connection between our Google Forms account and Zapier is actually set up. So luckily for us, the test was successful and Zapier managed to find a dummy, like a test Google Forms response. So as you can see, this is all dummy data just to test the Zap. So the respondent email is John Doe, the respondent name is sample text question answer. So this is not real data, but this data is here for you just to create the Zap, just to test it. But in reality, once this Zap is saved, the certificates will be issued using real data, the data of people who actually submit their responses. So let's move on and hit continue. And now we have to set up the action part. So the action of our Zap is the issuance of certificates via Certifier. Again, you can also issue badges via Certifier, but for the purposes of this video, I'll be issuing certificates. So let's select Certifier and the event issue credential. So credential is a general name for both a certificate and a badge. Don't worry. And let's go with the continue button. The next step that we have to do is to connect our Certifier account to Zapier. So we have to do exactly the same thing that we've done here when we were connecting our Google Forms account to Zapier. So let's click here. You have to click on the button connect a new account. According to what we see, in order to connect your Certifier account to Zapier, you have to provide the access token. So you have to firstly generate this access token in Certifier and then copy and paste it here. The access token can be generated in the settings developers access token. Here we are. Let's hit this button, generate access token. Let's call it Zapier and press continue. Certifier has generated us the access token, and now we have to copy it. It is very important that you do it straight away, because it is the only time when you can actually interact with your access token. It is the only time, so please make sure to copy this token and then store it in a secure, safe place. So once I am sure that I copied everything, I go back to this screen and paste my access token here. By pressing yes continue, I'm sending this access token to Zapier, and let's now check whether my account is connected. Great, my Certifier account was successfully connected to Zapier, so I can move on, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. Now we have to set up the action. So as you remember at the beginning of this video, I was telling that in order to set up a Zap, you need to have a Certifier account with at least one group, and this is exactly the moment when this information comes into play. So let's open Certifier and create this group. I go here, go to groups, and press this button, create group. So I'll create like a test group with dummy data just for the purposes of this video. Let's call it webinar. I will leave the learning event link blank. And let's quickly create the design, our certificate design. Again, you can also add a badge to your group, you can issue just badge, but I would like to use certificates for the purposes of this video. I would like to go with this template. Let's save this template. So when it comes to the group's creation, there is just one step left. We have to select the email template. I'll go with this default certificate delivery template, but you can always create a custom email template with your company logo and colors and with your like tone of voice, because you can change the text and subject line and even the sender email. That's very cool, but this is not something that I'll be doing for the purposes of this video, so I'll just leave the default settings. And let's hit the create button. So once we've successfully created a group, let's go back, let's refresh this page and select the groups that we've just created from the drop-down menu. Here we are. Here is our webinar group. And now we have to set up two more attributes, the recipient name and the recipient email attributes. Basically, we need to tell Certifier from which form fields it should take the information about recipient name and the information about recipient email. These attributes are very important because the recipient name is displayed on your certificate template and the recipient email is used to distribute the certificates via Certifier. So here is our form, and here we have the field called name and email address, so this field should be also present here. So when it comes to the recipient name, where we have it, here it is, name, the field that we need, and the recipient email, so respondent email, great. We've mapped the recipient name and email attributes. Now it is time to set up the issue credential field, and there are two ways, so you can either leave it as it is by default, leave it to true, or to change this field to false. So what does it mean? Once filled as true, a Certifier certificate will be automatically generated and sent via email to everyone who submits their response. So Certifier certificate won't be only generated but distributed as well. But if you change this field to false, it means that the Certifier certificate will be generated and saved as draft on your Certifier account. So you can come at some time in the future, select all of those generated certificates and publish them yourselves, like send them via email to your recipients. I personally prefer when everything is fully automated, so I would like to go with this option and leave the issue credential field to true. Then we have two more fields, the issue date field and the expiry date field. So my personal recommendation is to leave the issue date field empty, because it means that the issue date of your certificate or badge will be exactly the same day when your Zap is triggered. So imagining that we are saving this Zap right now and again, let's imagine that it's triggered tomorrow, we'll have the 24th of November as the issue date of our credentials, of our certificate or a badge, in my case, certificate. But if your case requires something else, for example, if in your case your issue date should be some date in the future or date in the past, then of course you can populate this field with any kind of date that that you prefer. When it comes to the expiry date, by populating this field, you can tell Certifier when the certificates that are issued when the Zap is triggered should expire. So if you need to issue certificates that expire in the future, like at some moment in the future, you have to provide this data here. So I'll leave both fields blank. Let's hit the continue button. And now we have to test the action. So right now, Zapier takes the information from our dummy response, sends it to Certifier, and creates a certificate with that dummy data. So let's wait a bit, and if the test is successful, we'll see this dummy certificate in our Certifier dashboard. So according to Zapier, the test is complete. A credential was sent to Certifier about 3 seconds ago. Let's check this out. Let's go to Certifier, to the section Certificates or Credentials. And everything is correct. We see this dummy certificate. In Certifier, we see that it has this dummy name, sample text question answer, and the dummy email John Doe created for the group called Webinar. So everything works correctly, and according to the results of our test, our Zap is correctly set up. The only step that's left is to press this Publish Zap button, and you are good to go. So each time when a new Google Forms response is received, a Certifier certificate will be automatically generated and distributed to the person who submitted this form. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, everything is very easy, so it takes me up to 3 minutes to set up a Zap between Certifier and any other application, so I'm more than sure that you also won't find it difficult. I would like to recommend you go and create your Zapier and Certifier accounts and try to set up some test Zaps just to see how everything works by yourself. Trust me, you'll be surprised at how easy it is to automate the certificate issuing process and save time for the things that really matter. Make sure to check the description box of this video for some useful resources on the certificate automation processes, on the certificate design, badge design, on using certificates as a part of your marketing, setting up different integrations, and so on and so forth. It was Uliana here with you, and thank you very much for your attention. Goodbye.